Hello everyone, and welcome back to another video, and back to another football video, exactly, because I'm talking about Serie A Match Day 21, which is gonna be played this weekend, and also Monday and Tuesday. Here are the standings right now. Napoli leads comfortably, 13 point lead to Inter, and then there are Lazio, Atalanta, and AC Milan as well with 38 points, I believe. So, first game is going to be it's going to be one of three games which are played in Saturday, at 3 o'clock, at local time. As always, these are local times. At least I tried to find this. So Cremonese plays against Lecce. Cremonese, of course, the last place team right now with 8 points, as you can see. Cremonese, obviously, the last game they played was against Roma, and they famously won that one, the quarter final in Coppa Italia. And yeah, and Lecce has lost 2 games in a row, so let's see if Cremonese's cup run affects them positively in this match day 21. Then Roma and Empoli play against each other at 6 p.m. Roma, of course, as I said, with Cremonese. They lost against Cremonese in the quarterfinals of Coppa Italia, and they obviously try to make it so that they don't lost a second game in a row, although I think they lost also their last league game, so that's not very great. And Empoli, their undefeated streak is impressive, but I believe it's been a while since they lost their last game, and that's the reason why they're 10th, much higher than I had expected at the start of the season. Then at 20:45 in the evening, the last game of Saturday, Sassuolo and Atalanta play against each other. Obviously, Atalanta is huge favorite in that one, but Sassuolo is coming off an impressive 5-2 win away from home against AC Milan. But it's fair to keep in mind that Atalanta hasn't lost in a while in the league. They lost against Inter in the cup, but in the quarterfinals as well. Then there are 4 Sunday games, the earliest of them starting at 12:30, Spezia against Napoli, who are the league leaders right now. Spezia has lost 2 in a row. Napoli, on the other side, has won 4 in a row, so let's see how this will pan out. But yeah, Napoli still has only lost only one game in the whole season, at least in Serie A. And yeah, that's gonna be an interesting one, to see if Napoli can, maybe if Inter struggles against AC Milan, maybe Napoli can increase the lead and get a step towards the title. Then 3 p.m. Torino and Udinese play against each other. Torino and Udinese, both of them, I believe, drew their last game in Serie A, and Torino lost to Fiorentina in the cup. I believe it was 2-1, if I'm not mistaken, in the Coppa Italia quarterfinals. So that's gonna be interesting. They're right next to each other in the table, 8th and 7th. Then 6 p.m, Fiorentina and Bologna play against each other. Fiorentina, as I said, won the Coppa Italia quarterfinal match against Torino, and Bologna is coming off a home win against Spezia. Then the late game on Sunday, which is probably the best game and one that I would watch from this match day 21, is Inter Milan against AC Milan. So Battle of Two Milan teams. Inter, obviously, they won Atalanta in the cup game, the Coppa Italia. And Milan, on the other side, has lost last three games in a row, and it hasn't been close either. If you count the game they lost against Inter in the Super Cup final, Italian Super Cup, which they lost 3-0 against Inter, and it was quite recently. They have, in the last three games, I believe, they have scored 2 goals and conceded 12. So that's not very good. So Milan is looking to bounce back, but Inter obviously isn't gonna try to help them, as they try to still win the league, even though 13 points lead for Napoli is quite a lot. Then there are two Monday games, Hellas Verona and Lazio. Lazio, third team right now in the league. They lost against Juventus in the cup recently, again in the Coppa Italia quarterfinals. Hellas Verona trying to do something so that they wouldn't get relegated. But yeah, they drew their last game, but they need wins if they want to get out of the relegation zone. Then the later one in the Monday, that one was 6:30, if I didn't tell it. But 8:45 game is going to be Monza-Sampdoria. Monza has surprised me this season, but Sampdoria not in a very good way. They are 19. Monza won Juventus in their last game 2-0, so that was impressive. Sampdoria, at their side of the story, they have lost 4 in a row, if I'm not mistaken. So, yeah, I would probably take Monza, but maybe Sampdoria could be desperate for points and maybe get a win for a while. First in a while. Then Tuesday game, the same time as Monza-Sampdoria starts, but on the other day, 20:45, Salernitana and Juventus play against each other. It's gonna be interesting because, as I said, Juventus lost their last league game against Monza, but they won their last Coppa Italia game over Lazio, so it's going to be interesting one. And Salernitana won against Lecce in their last game in the league. So, yeah. And Juventus, I believe, haven't won. It's now 3 games where they haven't won in the league. So, yeah. So, my recommendation for watching would be obviously Inter and AC Milan. And maybe Roma and Empoli. Roma should be fired up in that game. But let me know your thoughts about this match day 21 games in the Serie A in the comments down below. And hit the like and subscribe if you so want. And have a nice day.